here. I've become Mrs. Volatile with all of these stains and paints, and the polyurethanes and high glosses. So much so, now I've broken out on my face, and I'm like, well, if I do this vlog tonight, I have to wear these. I'll show you them. It actually covers them up. It's that terrible. Yeah. It's because of this, the ingredients in these volatiles, I'll call them the volatiles, the breathing of it, all of it, just touching the paint. Anyway, I have an answer that I read about, and I feel like a total fool now because I've been using all of these terribles, and now I found out, oh, there was another way. Okay, so we'll go Miss Health way. I guess use me as an example. Don't break out. Use just basic vinegar. Now this is a distilled white vinegar and it's very cheap. You can get it by the gallon. And then you take a steel wool. Now this is 24 hours. You put them together. It doesn't have to be that whole gallon. But you take this steel wool and you put it in the vinegar. And you soak it. It's a very simple process. The whole thing is going in there, and apparently it creates a reaction that breaks down the steel wool and it becomes stained water. Like such a stained water that it is the same type as you put it on wood, you have a wood stain. And it's essentially, you don't have to breathe any fumes, you don't have to hurt yourself going through respirators. And all of that. So here it goes. I'm putting it in this regular Marnar jar. There it goes. And it's gonna stay there for 24. And I'm gonna have like a stain. And this one is gonna be like a brown stain. You can if you do half, if you do pull it out and you do half water, you end up with a gray stain. So you can do gray, you can do the browner, you can do more of a caramel stain. You can use rusted nails also. Anyway, I gotta go. Anyway, yes, all locked. All the doors are locked. I'm locked tight. Yes, so here we are, locked up tight in this house and with my terrible horn on my head because of volatiles. Weeks, this is maybe my second week of exposure, and my body is not liking it. So, yeah, brain clarity, everything. So, I'm off to the land of staining, and you can stain over painted wood, you can stain unpainted wood, of course. And then at the end, after you're done, then you wax. Then you use regular, some kind of a good wax over the whole thing. Like I said, you can use a carnauba, you can use a beeswax, furniture polish, whatever. But you get a wax on after you've got the stain. And that's it. It's a very simple process, and you did not have to breathe a harsh chemical. So this is not going to be a harsh chemical to breathe or apply. So you can also use balsamic vinegar. Now balsamic vinegar makes another type. Sorry about my head, I look horrible today. Balsamic vinegar, or the other one, which is the, you can use apple cider vinegar also. So check it out, go to look at all of those websites. There's one person, a blog I was at yesterday, I'll leave a link to it. And they did do quite a bit of like a photos of this is the wood and the different stages and the different types of vinegar, really. And it really is only ever vinegar and this emulsion with the steel wool. Now, if you're not using a steel wool and you don't have any of this really great steel wool, then you can use rusted nails and just fill up with rusted nails. And I actually don't have any rusted nails handy, but it makes a different tone, a different stained tone with the rusted nails. So those doors behind me, you see them, I'm gonna stain them also. I'm looking for a quiet brown. I don't know if I can find it, but I'm hoping so. I'm very much hoping so. So 24 hours and this little doll is gonna be ready, and I'm not gonna have any fumes. No fumes. Fume free. Volatile-free.